Hello everyone and welcome to another the DIY workshop tutorial. In this video we will show you how you can replace the rear brake pads on a 2015 Nissan Qashqai equipped with electric parking brake system. In this episode we will retract the actuator using a diagnostic tool, but I will add a link in the description to one of the tutorials in which we've done it manually. Both options are correct, but of course using a diagnostic tool can help you save a lot of time. Okay guys, let's get this tutorial rolling. First, loosen up the lug nuts, raise the car, remove the lug nuts and the wheel, and then place a jack stand under the control arm or the rear axle for safety. We then retracted the actuator using a diagnostic tool. On this Nissan, no matter the diagnostic tool, you will get this message. Don't worry, you can turn off the ignition until the brake pads are replaced and then turn it on again. You will hear this loud noise until it's full retraction. Let's go behind the brake caliper for a better view. Remove the connector from the electric motor socket. Loosen up one of the two 13mm pin bolts using a 13mm socket and a 17mm wrench for the guide pin. Do the same for the next bolt. Take out the two bolts and pull the caliper firmly towards you until it can slide off the brake pads. Never leave the caliper hanging just by the brake lines. Use a piston press to retract the caliper's piston. Remove the old brake pads. Use a large flat file and a metal wire brush to remove the rust from the rotor and the caliper bracket. In order to understand which of the new brake pads goes on the outside and which one goes on the inside, just check the wear marks on the old brake pads. Obviously, you can tell that this one has to go on the piston side. The new TRW brake pads also came with replacement instructions and two types of protective metal plates. The plates are designed to help the brake pads slide on the caliper's bracket with less friction. Also, they do not rust as fast. So this brake pad goes on the outside. And this one goes on the inside. Apply some ceramic grease to the side metal clips and the slides of the caliper bracket. Make sure you don't apply grease to the rotor, but if you do by mistake, clean it with brake cleaner and a cloth or paper towels. When placing the caliper over the brake pads, make sure the pin goes inside the piston's head. We'll be right back. You'll know it went inside when there is no more gap between the brake pad and the piston. Now all the operations in reverse. Tighten the guide pin bolt up to 35 Newton meters. Don't forget to insert the electrical connector back in the motor socket and then end the brake shaft with the diagnostic tool. Put the wheel back on, remove the jack stand, lower the car and tighten the lug nuts up to a torque of 140 Newton meters. And that was it, guys. Thank you very much for watching. If this video was helpful, don't forget to subscribe for free, like or leave a comment. Until next time, we wish you all the best and remember, the DIY workshop saves money. Bye bye.